My family never knew what I did. I have cousins that, what do you really do again? I mean, they've known me my whole life and they don't know what I do. My name is Lawrence Gartell, and I am a digital media artist, and I've been doing digital art for 30 years and counting. It's funny because people don't recognize me as a photographer. I can establish myself more by saying that I'm more like Man Ray, or more like Robert Rauschenberg, who used photography as an image-making device so that they could make their art. In that sense, I mean, the photo is the photo base. I guess the controversy has always been more technical people who know perhaps better lighting techniques and traditional ways of taking a picture. But to me, art is always about breaking the rules and giving new insight into a new forecast. If I was just a regular photographer, I would have never have come upon the digital age, and I could have never have had the career that I had. I start out with a photograph, and then I go ahead and I alter it and enhance it through technical tools using the computer as a creative device. And I'll use a myriad of different programs, far before Photoshop ever got onto the playing field as the industry standard, let's say, for manipulating photos. There's been hundreds of programs to be able to do things. And prior to that even, when I started out in media study, it was all analog systems, all knobs and buttons, and you had to tweak and you had to change, and there was a matrix board and you had to set things so that one thing routed to another thing and that thing routed to another. 99% of my art is my own photography, my own pictures. I'm taking my own photographs all the time, and it's mine. It's not like I'm using somebody else's work and collaging it into my piece. If it is like that, then it's a matter of, let's say, taking an old ad or something that was used for something and add it into the collage and manipulate it and change it. But it was my photo taken of that thing. It's not like, oh, I used somebody else's. I think that's what's so different, is that it's so personal. I mean, everything I do is very autobiographical. Andy Warhol was not a technical person, and I had met him because I was going to Studio 54 all the time. Everyone was there. We struck up a conversation about art and stuff, and I told him what I was doing. He was very interested, and he had the commission to do the cover of Debbie Harry's next album, and he wanted me to show him how to use the Amiga computer. Went to his studio and showed him Deluxe Paint. I don't know if he'd be able to do it without me, but I could certainly say he didn't know how to use the computer and I helped him through it. The Absolute campaign that I did in 1991 was on the back cover of Art in America, Art Forum, Sotheby's, Wired Magazine, Scientific American, and New York Magazine. And that was really huge exposure. Not only that, but the ad ran for 10 years. So I have to say that regardless, it definitely had big impact, and a lot of people saw it. If you had an Absolute ad, you were like a made man. I did the cover of Forbes in 1989. I mean, that's pretty commercial, but it was the first digital cover that they ever did. And, you know, how would you do a cover otherwise today, you know? But back then, that was like absolutely revolutionary to have something that was digital to be on the cover of a magazine and to be used in a commercial way. Coca-Cola was for the Olympics in 1996, so it was really quite huge also. But more importantly about that is the fact that they gave me creative freedom, because if you look and see how Coca-Cola works, everything is really to the letter. I had things that were off the page. I had the word Coke and Coca-Cola in the same piece. I mean, that never happened. And instead of having art directors, there were attorneys that looked at that work. So they had to make sure that everything was perfect, and I had it up running up the side of a rocket even. A little bit of the word was off. I mean, they've never allowed that before. So I think for them, they said, you know, let's roll with this. Let's let this guy do his thing. And I think that's been the best part of my career, is that people hire me to do my work and they give me the creative freedom to express myself, and I'm basically their spokesperson, I'm their voice of what they're trying to say. Elvis is an American icon, and I think that he really has done a great, tremendous service to this country. First of all, he was a soldier, and I think that he was basically one of the greatest Americans that ever lived. A phenomenal talent, just like Picasso in that sense. It's like the work that keeps on giving, and that's what great art does. It just keeps on giving and giving, and it keeps on getting better all the time. Art is great work that moves you, that brings you to your knees, that makes you cry, that makes you happy, that just changes your day and gives you thoughts that are everlasting. I was asked to create the tour art for both Britney and Justin. They were not allowed to be together. It was like you shoot one and then you shoot the other one. And she goes, well, where's your crew? Where's your people? Where's your Polaroids? Where's the this? And where's, I said, honey, I said, the real people just have all they need in their pocket. And I pulled this out and I photographed her with a point and shoot camera, and the results were spectacular. I think that that's kind of what I'm offering, is 30 years worth of showing you the history of the digital media from start to finish to when I end.